Hello everyone, I am so excited because I am with a super talented woman, a writer, a female from Mexico. ¡Bravo! Ligia, ¿cómo estás?
Hola, muy bien, gracias. Hola a todos, ¿cómo están?
Ligia, 10 years ago you didn't write a movie 10 years ago, it was 16 years ago, right?
Yeah, it was 16 years ago. The script was written actually in 2000. And then the movie got released in 2008. So it was an 8-year trajectory to get the movie made.
Wow. How many rewrites did you do?
Oh, dozens. Actually, dozens of rewrites. So the first draft, like the one that was done in 2000, it was like two drafts. And then after that, once I got Patricia involved, who's the director of the film, I received, many, many notes from her and also for the producers. At one point, we were with the studio, so getting notes from them as well. So it was about a dozen rewrites on.
Was there a moment where you were like, oh, fuck this?
Through the entire time. Because that's, it's your baby and it's your characters and it's your story. And so when somebody else comes in and tells you to change things, it's always like very personal and it can be very emotional. But at the end of the day, if you have a good director who understands what you're trying to do, really all they want to do is make the movie better. And so you realize that that's what the notes are about and you try to address them as well as you possibly can.
And when did you discover your passion? Like, were you a kid and you discovered it, or you were like, a doctor in the middle of a surgery?
I mean, it was a completely by surprise. I actually went to school to become a ballroom dance, professional dancer. I went to Brigham Young University and I was part of the ballroom dance company there, which is considered the best amateur dance company in the country. And then I ended up having a lot of injuries and found out that I had a bone density issue in my body that actually stopped my dance career before it even started in my senior year of college. And I came to Los Angeles. I was an executive for over 10 years in development in television and film. And it was in that job that kind of inspired me to eventually transition to writing. So writing was not something that I really sought out, and it was a complete mistake that it ended up that I actually could do it, and I've been writing ever since.
Wow, congratulations. Any tip for all the writers out there?
Yeah, so the tip that I always give, because I also teach, so I have a lot of students, I always say work on your craft. It's not enough for you to want to tell your story. You have to learn about structure and you have to learn about format and how to tell a story. So if you're serious about becoming a writer, take a lot of classes and work on your craft, always. I still go to a writer's group every Monday to continue to work on my craft. So that would be my biggest advice.
Oh my God. And I wanted to ask you something that I was in the Q&A and you mentioned that the script was written in English. And why you wrote it in English if you wanted to be in Spanish?
Because I came to this country when I was 11 years old.
Okay.
So I don't know the slang in Spanish anymore. I would have been writing it as a 12-year-old, really. And so it was much easier. And, just the fact that you speak that language doesn't mean that you can write creatively in that language. And so all of my classes in writing were in English. All of my writing was in English. And so the script was written in English. And then we went to Mexico. And right before production, we translated it into Spanish.
Well, thank you so much. It was an honor to meet you, to interview you, and to see your beautiful work. Thank you so much.
I hope you guys check it out. La misma luna.
And where can people take your class?
So I teach at Cal State LA and in the MFA program, and I also teach at USC Film School, also both in the undergrad and the MFA program. I do workshops for NALIP, the National Association of Latino Independent Producers, and things like that. So
perfect. Now we know. We are going to stalk you a little.
Okay.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. Guys, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Find me on Facebook. Follow me on Twitter. And support the movie behind me, Overboard, with the talented Eugenio Derbez. Adios.